my May, my daughter. I put my love into photographs, pictures, took space in my heart instead of people.
This was supposed to be a date.
It is a date.
I love you.
I might upset some of my Anglo-Saxon followers, but don't take this the wrong way. But involving this movie to photograph, one thing that I can say is, ain't black love so beautiful? And don't take that the wrong way, ladies and gentlemen. And we're going to talk about the photograph. I saw it. I took my wife to see it this weekend. Good movie. I wanted to love it, but I liked it. And I'm going to break it down for you why I came to my assessment. If you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to the channel. Be sure to turn on the notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. Follow me on Instagram. Whenever you have stories, movies, TV shows, anything you want me to cover, everybody has been hitting me up on Instagram with news. I try my best to get your stories up here and give you the credit and send people to your Instagram to grow your following as well. Also, follow me on the podcast. The Photograph came out over this weekend. It is a romantic drama film written and directed by Stella McGee. It follows the estranged daughter, played by Issa Rae, of a famous photographer who falls in love with the journalist Lakeith Stanfield, assigned to cover her late mother. Ladies and gentlemen, the movie, it was just so good to see all this melanin on screen. All these great African-American actors on screen. Issa Rae, you know, what can you say about her? She has range. Lakeith Stanfield, he's got range. It also starred Courtney B. Vance, who was Issa Rae's father. And it had some other great, great actors in this thing. You have Issa Rae's character. The story really revolves around another story. So you do have the love and romance going on between Issa Rae and Lakeith Stanfield. But it's basically talking about Issa Rae's mother and her love of the biological father to Issa Rae. That story was, in some cases, more compelling than the contemporary story of Issa Rae getting with Lakeith Stanfield, who was playing Michael Block. I was more intrigued by that backstory of what was going on with that mother who had a lot of problems with her mother than I was kind of the Issa Rae story. That's the part that I said I wanted to love it, but I liked it. Now, overall, everything, every element you want from a romantic movie, you had it. You had a love, a deep love. You had a connection. You had issues that preempted both parts of these individuals wanting to date each other, having issues in the past that created them not wanting to commit. You had old boy who was a rolling stone somewhat. He never really wanted to settle down. You had Issa Rae who had some issues with a dude in the past that actually proposed to her and she said no and left him hanging. And these two wind up meeting together, liking each other. But in the end, it kind of felt like homeboy chose his job over his love, but he really didn't, because when he found out he was going to be going somewhere else, and I'm not going to try to spoil the whole thing, he came to Issa Rae and said, I like you. I want to be with you. I just want to make it work, but I've got this job that's going to take me out of the country. How can we make it work? But Issa Rae was at an impasse at that point, because after they smashed, fellas, I can tell you right now, if you smash with a woman and you don't call her back the next day, she's gonna have thoughts. She might wanna dismiss your ass. And that's kind of what happened with him. He smashed with her, didn't call her back for a couple of days, runs into her by accident at her real biological father's house when she talked to her biological father after she's an adult and broke it down to him that he was her daddy and that for all these years, she didn't know that he was her daddy. And the biological father was like, when y'all visit me in the past, I should have just asked your mother, because he had no real idea and he was afraid to ask. So you basically show up to this woman's father's house while she's just meeting her father after however many years it's been of Issa Rae's age. And then you just, you know, look at her and be like, you know, I didn't know how to tell you, blah, blah, blah. So that could have been a very hairy situation. And this story did really good by taking that and just kind of propelling the story so that the movie wouldn't draw out too long. Everything that was good about this story, cinematography was great, the pictures was great, the acting was outstanding, all that black skin on the screen was outstanding, the love story was outstanding. But to me, the best story was the background story of Issa Rae's mom and her dynamic with the biological father, and actually her relationship with her mother. That was kind of a better story. I almost feel like you could make a mini series out of that part if they really wanted to continue this movie universe. Now, that's not to knock Issa Rae and Lakeith Stanfield, because they did their thing too. But more intrigued was the backstory of Issa Rae's mom in this story. Overall, I'm going to give the story a 7.5 because I enjoyed seeing all these people on screen. I enjoyed them displaying that, you know, minorities can really hit it out the park. Minority can do any genre of movie if you ask us to do it. You give us an opportunity to do it, and they did just that. But did you guys go see it? Leave me your comments if you've seen it. The Life Gain Scale is 7.5. Whether or not you should go pay for this, I want you guys to go and see it so you're supporting these type of films. But if I didn't have that mindset, I would say you can wait. But the movie is good. It's better than what I thought when I went in, because I didn't know what to expect going in. And I liked that whole backstory. That really made the movie have a little bit more substance. But leave me all your comments. What do you think? Where did I get it wrong? Where did I get it right? That's gonna do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe. Go get yourself that life game. Follow me on Instagram. Hit me up on Instagram. I will shout you out when you give me good stories and things to present on YouTube. Also, follow the podcast. And until that next sexy as hell video, I'll see you.